drugs that were designated back home for nuclear testing by the United States government. I am a direct descendant of survivors of those nuclear testing. The second picture is a screenshot of the Marshall Islands Consulate, where I'm currently interning right now as my capstone for school. That picture up there is my elementary school that taught me all the basic things that I need to know in life. It's where I grew up and I spent, you know, my whole entire life, and this Patty was there. And then I graduated from AL High School in 2013. Now I'm a student at UH Manoa. I run on coffee and caffeine. And there's my daughter, 2-year-old Mia. So why did I choose to go to college? Are any of you interested in college?
Many times actually.
failed my family when I got pregnant, and it wasn't a fun experience, but my daughter has become a blessing to me, and I know that my family is very proud of my daughter and my me today. And so it's okay to fail, because when I failed, I lost my scholarship. I failed school and I failed my teachers. I failed everyone who believed in me. But that's when I knew I had to get back up and finish school. And so that's why I'll be graduating in 3 weeks. So, I mean, it was a tough road getting here, and it was hard, but, you know, my scholarship, they gave me chances. They gave me 3 chances. They gave me probation and then another probation, and then they finally cut off my scholarship, and then I had to pay for school on my own, which was only on FAFSA, which all of you can do. I was only on financial aid, and they financially covered my tuition while I was at the community college in Kapilani. And then after that, after that, you know, I was able to raise my GPA and I got my scholarship back. So if you fail, don't ever be afraid to get back up, because it is possible. Anything is possible. My GPA was all the way down there. It was almost negative. But, you know, I'm here today. And I mean, you just have to work hard, and you have to remember the people who sacrificed for you to be where you are. And it's all about, you know, sacrificing. It's all about commitment. It's all about passion. And you have to want to be in college. And I encourage each of you to go to college, because it'll be a very fun experience. You know, there's going to be a lot of things that come along the way, and you'll have trials and tribulations. Some of you might even take a semester off because, you know, you have family to care for, or you want to, like, work at this job because it makes money. But it's always important to finish college, because once you do finish college, you'll have all these networking options or opportunities available for you. And when you are in college, it's not just you, it's not an independent thing. You're there, you're taking your country with you, and you're taking your people with you to college. So it's very important to, you know, go to college. And so that's my message. Don't ever give up. And that's my daughter, that's at my graduation photo. And then, so if you need help, I'm here to help whoever is interested in applying for community college, colleges. If you want to apply for a UH system, I don't know what the deadline is for January, but the deadline to apply for fall, for August, was last month. I think it was like on March 1st, so I'm sorry, that's kind of late, but I can still help you apply for community colleges. I can help whoever is interested in applying for financial aid. Everyone will get into community college. It's not like a, no, you won't be in community college. They take anyone who applies. And to me personally, I suggest going to community college because it's the cheaper option, but you also get closer with your professors because they don't, like, the classrooms are even smaller than this, and you'll get close to your peers and stuff.
My students here, they're 10th graders right now.
Oh!
So it's never too early to think about college.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's good that she's saying, oh, if it's too late now, it's too late now. But that's for the seniors, right?
Oh, yeah.
So she's giving you a heads up. Like, when you're planning on going to college, you be thinking about going to college this time in April when you're a senior. You'd be thinking about making plans, like, next year as a junior.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The good thing too with Farrington, they have a pretty high percentage of students who take college classes
while they're here.
So are any of you planning on taking college classes in the next couple of years? Okay. Can you speak to how that might be an advantage for students?
Yeah. So I had friends in high school who were actually taking community college courses. And I mean, to their advantage, when we graduated high school, I'm graduating college now like 5 years later, but they graduated college 3 years ago because they already started when they were in high school. And it's never too late to start early, you know? So, and I also hope for our high scholarship, if you know any Marshallese who are interested in applying for the Marshallese scholarship. And then I also collaborate with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs at home to help whoever wants to go to school in Taiwan. You know, they take Pacific Islands. Citizens, so I think it's any Pacific Islander. So if you're interested, you can just let me know and I'll ask them. We'll go through the whole interview process and all that. And they'll be interviewing you through
no, she gave you a lot of good information to try to digest. Anybody have a question?
Like any question. It doesn't have to be about school.
What's your question?
I have a question. When you were failing and your GPA was really low, were you feeling like you wanted to give up?
No.
You ever felt that way?
No, I mean, I kind of felt hopeless, sort of, but I didn't want it to get to me. I didn't want my mistakes to define me. Not saying that my daughter is a mistake, but I didn't want everyone to look at me like, oh, she's a failure. She just dropped out because of this. You know, I wanted to succeed for my daughter and for my family. So, failure was never really, looking on my head.
Right. So I was thinking kids that are in 10th grade right now, they're going to junior year, they might be realizing they may not have enough credits to graduate. And so is it too late for them, you think, or do they have a lot of time?
Yeah, I think you have a lot of time to make up your credits. You know, you have 2 more years, so you can do a lot of things to make up for those credits. So I think you all are safe.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, people feel like once they're under, it's really a tough feeling. And so I think Ariana's trying to say that you just have to dig deep inside and decide what's more important for you to be able to overcome, because she's an example of getting past a lot of obstacles. She overcame them. And so I think if she's being an example to you that whatever you might be going through, like at this moment, or even in the future, it is possible.
Yeah, nothing is just believe in yourself. You have to start believing in yourself. You know, it's very important. And I think most of the reason why I failed when I was pregnant was that I gave birth to my daughter during midterms, which was born on October 6th. And that's totally in the middle of midterm. And I was in the hospital emailing my professors sorry, I'm in labor. I cannot do my midterm right now and all that. So it was kind of crazy, but it's okay.
That's right. You got through it. You'll be graduating.
Yeah.
Next month, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
You're all invited, by the way.
Anybody have a question? Naomi, what were you thinking?
And what are you majoring in?
Majoring in political science, but I'm more into working with the community and, helping people. To be honest, I don't really know what I'm going to do with political science, but that's all about life. Life is about figuring out who you are, so.
Right. But once you have your college degree, that opens up many doors that you wouldn't have had if you only had a high school degree, right?
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention back home, $2.50 that's the minimum wage, but if you have a degree, it'll be $8 or $8.50.
That's how it is here too, anywhere.
Yeah.
The lower pay is the minimum wage without a college degree. As soon as you have a college degree, it jumps up considerably. Or even positions that's not a college degree, but you're certified in something, like people who, go to cosmetology school, auto mechanics, even blood drawers, the phlebotomists.
Yeah.
They, as soon as you're certified in something, your pay also goes up. Well, the bell's probably going to ring in just a second. Anybody else have a possible last question? What did you guys think? Thumbs up if you thought it was good?
Yeah.
All right. let's give her a, they call me Miss Smith here. Let's give you a Miss Smith hand. We do this so we don't disturb others.
Yeah. I remember.
Did I have you guys answer? Oh, see? Even way back in her time, when she was in fifth grade, we were doing this.
Yeah.
Okay, so.